So let's see here. What card do we have? Wow, but look at this. We got the King of Pentacles, generosity. So this looks like, things are changing in regards to our financial situation. This could be a generous gift. Like, I just feel there's a gift coming for some of us Virgos, and it could be in regards to some type of prosperity. It could be, some type of deal, some type of, yes, because we got stuff going on in our sixth and seventh. I mean, we are looking really good this month, Virgo, to have deals, contracts, partnerships, changes, learning, growing wisdom. There's so much happening, but I feel this King of Pentacles is a wonderful connection to knowing that there will be others who are going to help us prosper some way. We may be receiving a wonderful gift through some type of inheritance, maybe from some type of taxes. Maybe if we do our taxes this month, that may be what I'll be doing. But we want to wait until after March 10th to do our taxes. But that could be what is happening in our eighth house by the end of this month. If we get our taxes done by the end of this month, we may have some nice chunk of money to start some type of new beginning. So that's something to look forward to. So yes, let's pull another card in the second house of finances. But that is wonderful. That's why I feel Jupiter's blessing us somehow, some way this month. We are feeling the Jupiter energy really strong this month. And I feel that's what's giving us the confidence. We are ready to learn. We're ready to grow. We're ready to expand. However, is going to allow us to be who we need to be here. So we got two cards, and look at this, is no kidding, the house and the good luck. So I feel, wow, some of us are maybe selling a house, buying a house, but there's a good deal out there, a generous offer. So there may be a wonderful offer, a generous contract to buy or sell a house. But remember, wait till Mercury goes direct after March 10th to make any contractual decisions here. But this is about luck and success. It could be growing a business at home too and having a lot of success in that also. So let's go to the third house, and that's connection to communication. So let's see how our communication skills are going to seem like this month here, Virgo. We've got the Seven of Wands, challenges. So there will be some challenges in communications with others. So we do see that we're just going to have to be very careful to pick our battles. We may be having difficulties maybe with our third house could be our siblings, our relatives, our neighbors, our cousins. So there may be some challenges in regards to communication with our close family connection here. But I do feel with the Seven of Wands and the burdens of the Ten of Wands up there, that means that we are facing our challenges, getting through those burdens, and something is changing to allow us to grow and prosper, to be more confident, to have some type of new type of prosperity, I feel. So let's see one more card here in the third house. Oh wow, well, this may be some beautiful romance of love coming through, flowers. Yes. So and it could be a strong connection, maybe an earth energy, a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. I do see a strong connection to Leo energy. But yeah, there may be a strong connection to another earth energy for some of us. Challenges maybe in this relationship though, burdens. So, there may be something going on with a relationship that is facing some type of challenge, but I feel there's some type of romance through that, and there may be some type of change in a relationship that had been a challenge before. Maybe this is about something developing and ending. Something that was a burden is now coming into fruition, or something of that sort, if that makes sense. So let's go to the fourth house, and that's family and home. What do we have here? A progress, Two of Wands. So this is about making some choices in the family life that allowed for some type of progress to happen. And I know this makes sense to me, about making some choices in the family, for choices and decisions for the family that were going to be positive. positive, and it sure has been. So I feel a lot of us Virgos are looking at those choices and decisions so, you know, we can continually have the stability and happiness that we want in our family. But I also feel with that home, there may be, you know, like if you're trying to sell your home, that's maybe a month where there's progress. Maybe there's some type of deal, some type of agreement that's coming to you that's really, you know, going to be an offer that through maybe some challenges. I feel, yeah, some of us Virgos may be, you know, selling or buying a house, and there may have been some challenges in the past, but as Mercury goes direct, there may be some type of progress to make some choices. But I feel like for some of us Virgos who are selling a house or buying, it's a, you know, you're getting what you want. So let me pull another card here. Virgo in our fourth house of family and home here. Let's see. Virgo. We get two cards here. The Tree of Life and the Fox card here. So yeah, I feel there's progress. I feel like there's something coming for some of us Virgos in regards to maybe, like I feel like there may be an unexpected offer on a house, someone noticing, you know, where, you know, maybe some of us workers aren't even selling our house and someone's like, you know, I want that house. I want to live there. But there's something coming, I feel, for some of us Virgos in regards to our home and progress and choices that we're making. And I feel like it has something to do with, you know, a house. So that's cool. Let's go to the fifth house here. So that is all that energy in our fifth. I feel like just something happening in our fifth house, which is awesome because the fifth house is love, romance. So I'm thrilled to see what may develop. And Saturn will go to our sixth house by the end of this month. And Saturn has been in our fifth house for like 3 years, maybe restricting us from having more fun and love. So maybe this really is the time that as Saturn moves out of our fifth house and Mars being in our fifth house and Jupiter being in our fifth house, this may be a time of action, fun, passion, pleasure. So let's see what that card is for us Virgos in the fifth house. Here we go. Support, 10 of Pentacles here. So this is great. I'm seeing a lot of growth in ourselves, but this may be a connection to someone from the family in love. So there may be some support, some type of family connection in regards to love. But I see this connection to children. The 10 of Pentacles is the support of family. So I just feel like, you know, us Virgos, there's something about the family life that could be that things are really looking great in the family. Things are coming together. More stability, positivity. That's what I'm feeling. More connection, more support from the children here, Virgo. So one more card here. Ten of Pentacles is growing and prospering. From, you know, I just feel those who have a family business or a home business, this is the time where you'll receive the support and growth that you may be waiting for. Yeah, because you're going to receive help and assistance from those that are close to you. Sorry about that. My video just went off. But support from, you know, close friends, family. That's why I feel there's something great support this month from those that are close to you. And you can trust them. There's just a closeness with your children, Virgo. I just feel like, you know, if you're trying to grow and prosper in some type of creative endeavor, there seems to be some type of generosity, some type of offer, some type of deal, something that is helping us Virgos to get out there. So let's pull some love romance cards here. So let's see for love. We've got love definitely flowing, whoops, this month here. So these are too many cards. Let me just shuffle them up. So love. Let's see how our love energy is flowing here. First card, let go of control issues. So that's important this month, is if we are connecting with someone, just allow it to flow, to see, to let it be. Healing family issues. Well, isn't that beautiful? Because that's what I was talking about, that I feel there's just this beautiful flow with the family. So it looks like things are really positive. Healing family issues and the family coming together and feeling happy and positive. Oh, yes. Stay optimistic about our love life here. Okay. Positive affirmations will bring us love. So let's see here, Virgo. Let's pull another card for us in the love energy. Virgo, Virgo, Virgo. Okay. Give your relationship a chance here. So there may be something I feel from the past. There may be a situation, and that's why I feel there may be a challenge with some type of communication from someone from the past. So you may be thinking about giving a relationship a chance, but if someone does come from the past, I would advise just waiting until Mercury goes direct to see how the energy plays off. But I wouldn't be surprised if for some of us, Virgo, someone comes from the past, and you may want to think about giving that relationship a chance. You know, something very karmically may have happened to where the two couldn't come together at some time, but now this could be the right time for this to happen. So let's go to the sixth house, and that is where Saturn is going to stay for the next couple, 2 to 3 years in Aquarius. So that's our day-to-day life. For the next couple years, I feel we're looking at our life differently. We're going to restructure our day-to-day life, and it's going to be different and unusual. It's not going to be the stable, ordinary way that we've used to be. That's what I'm feeling. I've already thought of some really crazy and wonderful ideas and ways that I want to change my day-to-day life. So I'm sure a lot of you Virgos are thinking out of the box too. So yes, let's pull a card in the sixth house here. So what do we have here? Six of Swords, resolution, moving forward. So it does look like there's some resolutions, being able to move forward in our day-to-day life, moving forward in our ideas, moving forward on our work plans, moving forward on our health regime. So resolution, moving forward, that's good in our day-to-day life. Things are looking up for us, Virgos. So love that. Here, let me pull another card here for us Virgos in our sixth house. And so this is about us facing those burdens. That's why I feel, because we face those burdens and those challenges, we now can release them. You know, we have done the work to heal, right? And now there is going to be resolution through that suffering. That's what I'm feeling. Our day-to-day life, there's resolution, release from the karma, the suffering from the past, healing. So let's go to the seventh house. And yes, we've got Neptune and Mercury in there. And the sun will be in there for a little while. So we're focusing on relationships. We're focusing on contracts, deals, partnerships. So let's see what our seventh house is looking like here. Something positive, something coming about through communication. Two of Swords, uncertainty. So this is about receiving maybe an offer and uncertain about the choice that you need to make. But I feel there's support. I feel like as long as you wait until after March 10th to make a decision, I feel, you know, there is a generous offer coming for some of us Virgos. It may leave us uncertain, because I feel like some of us are going to have to leave, like all of a sudden, like you receive this offer. And now maybe that's why I'm seeing, like, you got to sell the house, you got to pack and move, and there's support from the family, or there's something in regards to that, which I love. So even though I feel there will be some choices in regards to maybe deals, contracts, uncertainty about love, I feel things will start to look more clearer by the end of the month here. Communication, yeah. There's something coming through communication for some of us Virgos that we're going to have to make a choice about. But I feel like it's allowing us to release us from the burdens, from things that have happened in the past, to allow us to move forward. Yeah, it's clearance. It's karma. It's finally having that transformation that is happening in our eighth house, by the end of the month, we'll have the sun there and that new moon by 24 March. So the eighth house is that huge major change that we are focusing on, a new beginning by the end of the month. Yeah, no kidding. Hello. That is the death card. That is the Scorpion energy. That is the eighth house. What does it say here? Angel of transformation. No kidding, Virgo. Are we ready for this transformation by the end of the month? Because something is coming that is allowing us to have something new. We're going to focus on the positive, and I feel it has something to do strongly with a situation in regards to work. And I feel some of us are going to have an opportunity to learn something, which is great. And the snake card, it's releasing of the karma, the burdens. This is a powerful time. Death, transform. We are shedding something by the end of this month here, Virgo. Let's embrace it. Let's take time to meditate upon it and what we are doing through this change and transformation. We need to make sure we stay grounded. You know, the eighth house is, you know, taking care of our psychological needs. It's connecting to the occult. It's really understanding this death and transformation that we are going through by the end of this month here. So yes, we need to embrace this beautiful change that we are having by the end of this month here. So the ninth house, we get Venus and Uranus hooking up in our ninth house of higher knowledge, of wisdom, of fun and adventure. So we may be meeting someone with that Venus energy and Uranus, meeting someone very different and unusual, maybe from another country. That's what I feel for some of us in love. We are going to meet someone different and unusual. So stay optimistic, because no kidding, there is a friendship. This is the Two of Cups. This is love. This is the soulmate energy. So yeah, some of us, I feel something unexpected is coming through the ninth house. It may be through learning something, because Uranus and Venus, this connection to learning something like tarot, astrology, the esoteric. So there may be a strong connection of meeting someone through that spiritual connection. But boy, I feel there may be a strong connection to someone that is coming from the past, a past lifetime, a friendship, a love, a soulmate, a union that's come together strongly. That's what your angels and guides want to let you know in the ninth house. Be prepared for this. It is going to be unexpected, and it is definitely going to be a beautiful, it could be a friendship. Maybe it is someone from the past is coming, and you need to give that relationship a chance. Maybe you were just friends, and now you're ready to maybe see if there's a deeper connection to love, because that's the eighth house, a deeper connection, making choices. Yeah, choices, number two. So there is definitely, for some of us, Virgos this month, making some choices about love, a friendship, a soulmate. Woo, that is wonderful to see there. That's why we're going through a beautiful transformation. Some of us are changing our life because of love. 10th house, that is our a career house, our destiny house. Let's see what's going on there. Luck, Page of Pentacles. You see the word luck? This is about learning. This is about luck coming. This is about Jupiter blessing us in our career, our destiny. This is about learning a skill. So yes, be ready. We've got our book in our hand, and we've got our pentacle that we're carrying. Yes, we have the King of Pentacles. We have the Ten of Pentacles. We have the Page of Pentacles. Wow, and we have the Two of Cups. We are definitely feeling Jupiter this month. We have a lot of luck for love, our creative flow, to prosper, to have fun, to enjoy ourselves. Yes, Virgo, we definitely are ready for it. We deserve it, don't we? So yes, prepare for that luck, a new beginning, making our wishes come true, fulfilling our hopes, wishes, and dreams, our happily ever after. That's what we have luck in. So 11th house, let's go to our 11th house. And that is our hopes, wishes, and dreams, connections to the right people, our friendships. Let's see here. Five of Cups, sadness. So there may be some separations in regards to friends. And that's why I feel some of us, Virgos, may be leaving our friends because of an opportunity to maybe move because of love or our job situation. But there is maybe some sadness that is coming because of some type of change and transformation that is happening for some of us Virgos here. So some type of, maybe some type of loss also could be happening here. But I feel, yeah, it is really just an emotional month because there's a lot of changes happening. And I feel like some of us are, you know, getting ready to, get ready to head off into, you know, uncharted territories and not feeling really anchored. But, you know, I feel like this is just going to be very emotional, but very exciting for us Virgos here. Wow. So last card here for our 12th house, Page of Swords, gossip. So I feel there's communication, something karmically coming to allow a new cycle to begin. And it's through some type of gossip, some type of communication. That is the word from your spiritual connection, that there will be some type of communication, some type of word this month to make some type of choice in regards to a huge transformation that may be in regards to a love connection, a commitment. It also could be a business deal because of so much happening in the seventh house. So this is a contract, a business deal, a commitment. And yes, I do feel there's a strong connection, wow, to an earth energy, for sure, another Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. But there is this energy of air, Gemini, Libra, or an Aquarius here for you.